And a note before we bring you this report by 360's Randi Kaye, some images may be disturbing, but it's important for you to see.
Rosa, nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
This is the only way we could see Rosa Felipe. The 41-year-old mother of two young boys has been hospitalized at Jackson Memorial Hospital in Miami since early March after testing positive for COVID-19. She's fighting to survive inside the very same hospital where she worked for more than 15 years as an electroencephalograph, or EEG, technician, testing brain activity in patients.
I do all of the EEGs wherever they're needed, whether it's in the emergency room or trauma or in a separate floor.
So you would travel around the hospital quite a bit and possibly got exposed?
Quite a bit.
You were seeing a lot of patients?
A lot of patients, yes.
Rosa has two underlying conditions that put her at even greater risk, asthma and diabetes. It got so bad, doctors put her on a ventilator to help her breathe.
I actually asked the doctor for a piece of paper before being intubated, and I wrote on the paper to my children, I wanted them not to give up and not to be upset with God, because this was, if something were to happen to me, this was his will. And I didn't want him to be upset with God. I wanted them to be loving and happy that God allowed us to have the time that we did have. And then after that, I just gave it all up to God.
Rosa spent 2 months on the ventilator. It saved her life.
I am still grateful that I'm alive. I'm grateful that I made it.
But now Rosa has another problem. While on the ventilator, she may have developed blood clots. Her hands were likely starved of circulation and oxygenation, so her fingers turned black.
My fingers are gonna fall off. Let me see if I can show you my hands.
Yeah, and that's because they weren't getting any blood.
Exactly. The left hand, which is in better shape.
Rosa's hands may have to be amputated. At the very least, she says, she will lose many of her fingers. Rosa's family wasn't sure she'd even survive. Her sister told me she was already planning her funeral. What keeps Rosa going is the thought of seeing her children again, who she hasn't seen since she was hospitalized in March.
When do you think you'll be able to see your children again?
For me, it can't be soon enough. But I know that in the end, I'm gonna be with them. I know that. So that's what keeps me focused, and it keeps me wanting to heal and wanting to get out of here fully restored.
Alone in her hospital room for more than 5 months now, Rosa admits she's had some dark thoughts. So more than ever, she treasures life's sweet joys.
On my behalf, could you please congratulate Anderson Cooper on his baby?
I certainly will. These are the things you think about when you're laying in the hospital bed.
Yeah, I'm happy that he has a baby and that he's so cute.
Well, I will share your blessings with Anderson and Wyatt.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Have a great day.
Be well.
Wow, Randi joins.
So sweet, right?
I mean, wow, what she has been through.
Yeah, and what she's still going through, Anderson. And yet that was the only time in our whole interview that she smiled, was talking about you and Wyatt. I mean, she's been in this dark place. She was on that ventilator for a couple of months. She's going through possibly losing her hands. She hasn't seen her children in a couple of months. She was in this dreamlike state where she was watching her life go by on the ventilator, she remembers. So it's been a really scary time for her, and she hasn't had any visitors. So when we started talking about you, that's when she really lit up. And I think she's really clung to that as sort of this bright spot in all of this. You know, we see what the pandemic has done to her and her family and so many others. And it was just really sweet, Anderson, that moment. And all she wanted to do was talk about you and baby Wyatt.
I want to talk to her. Thank you, Randi. Appreciate it. And we wish her the best. And we hope she gets to be reunited with her kids really soon.